that I could not put my fiber optic directly into the devices. So I need one more device, one more component that is known as a small home unit. Okay, this is a small home unit that is not a, it is a very micro version of a splitter that we put over here. So what we do, we put the fiber coming from the back end side, okay, and we have one more fiber which we put onto the to our home. So how we are going to connect, we have this such type of patch cord. Here the patch cord which I do have in my hand, it is a LC patch cord of single mode. So you can get a LC patch cord, you can get a SC patch cord. So it totally depends on our network requirement that what type of patch cord we are going to choose. So what will happen, we will take this patch cord, one is attached over here. Now I will use media converter, because now from a data center, from a distribution channel, from the splitter boxes, by all this passing, my fiber came to my home. Now I can put a media converter. You can see over here, there is a type of optical port. So what I will do, I will put my optical cable over here, and after this I can get my electrical signals over here. Now this is our requirement. Then you can plug in your system, your router, your switches to access the network. So this is, in this way, what we are happening, what we have seen from the data centers to the last mile customer, it could be my home, it could be my business, it could be my car. I can deploy a wholesale network from a data centers to the client side onto the fiber optics model. When you are coming onto the fiber optics technology, it means you are having a much more potentials to having a very high speed of data of downloading and uploading. As we know, there is a new concept of coming in our home that we are getting a triple play, voice, video, data. So it needs a lot of bandwidths to transfer all the information in a real time. So this is a model, this is taking a responsibility to give you each and every process in a very unique manner, in a very systematic manner, with a very high speed. Doesn't matter where we are sitting into our homes. So this is a part of FTTX network. As we deploy the network, as we design the network, our network is ready. Now the second best part which I want to make you aware, we have made you aware about the optical components. So we are again going to summarize the optical component with this FTTX model, because at any time if my fiber channel get down, how I am going to do the troubleshooting. So again, these components are going to play a very vital role. As I made you aware about the splicing machines, I made you aware about the optical power meter, we make us aware about the SFPs, OTDR and VFL meter. So this is a whole soul scenario that we need to use to make our FTTX model. So in this FTTX module, we are going to make you aware from the scratch to the top level, what is FTTX model, what is the requirement, what is the objective, what is the scope, why we are looking for this FTTX model. Before FTTX model, what was the technology that we are using to transfer our data from our data centers or from a big size to our last mile customer. So we are going to have a detailed study on this process. Not only this, we are going to have a practical implementation. We have a case studies. We will go and design all the parameters in a practical manner. We will use all these components in a practical to give you the realistic environment that the corporate company needs in any guy to go and implement the structure of FTTX model. So this is how we are going to make you aware with the whole soul scenario of fiber optics of FTTX model.